Okay, so based on popular demand, I decided to give the Logitech Brio another chance. You voted to see if I could make it look less like that kind of yellow or Oompa Loompa kind of default tone to make it match, you know, what I normally use, which is my Sony A7 full-frame camera. So we're gonna actually use Logitech G Hub and do some color correction inside of OBS just to see how close we can get it. So stick around for that and let's go. Okay, so now I've got the Logitech G Hub app open just to open up the Logitech Brio camera. So now I'll go into video. You can see it's pretty yellow right now. So everything's kind of this yellow orangey color. It's not faring too well. It looks okay, but it's not amazing. So let's close this app. Okay, so now I've got OBS open and I want to try a couple things there. So I'm going to go ahead and activate my camera in OBS. And once I do that, you're going to see it still looks pretty yellow because I'm still on all the defaults. So let's try some filters. So if I go into filters here, I'm going to show you what I've got in terms of color correction. So one thing that happens by default is if you look at the colors that are normally up. Now I'll copy this to my clipboard. But normally what happens is it's a complete white. The HTML is all Fs, so that means it's a white hue that's in there. And if I look at all these different things, normally the defaults are all zeroed out in terms of gamma, contrast, brightness, saturation, and those are the settings on OBS. Now, if I turn this back on, you can see that's not great. So what we need to do is some actual color correction. Now, the fun thing with the color correction is you might assume that, you know, if you put the, let's say we want to cancel out some of the peachy tones, so we'd probably go to something that's a bit more on the blue side. So if you try to go blue, you'll see that it looks very much like Violet from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. So the one thing with color correction in OBS is you want to stay pretty close to the bottom. So you want to stay, if I go to yellow, for example, that will make it very yellow. I can make it look like the movie. If you're a fan of The Matrix, I can kind of make it have that kind of matrixy look to it. Also, if I want to go, you know, to something a little bit more subtle, I can go to a purple. But the hue that I found worked pretty well, and I'll just paste it in now again, is this one. So now that's giving me a little bit of kind of rosy color, but it's more natural skin tone. It's closer. And now let's just move this over to the side here. So here is the Logitech Brio kind of tuned. You can see there's still not a ton of definition. If I go to the medium camera and the Brio's kind of in the frame here, there's a lot more dynamic range. If you look at, for example, the amount of detail that's on my forehead, eyebrows, you know, yeah, it kind of softens all the lines with the Brio, which is, you know, an effect that some people will want. But in terms of realism, if you look at what's coming out of the, you know, the camera that I'm looking at now, which is the Sony A7 Mark II, it is quite a bit more realistic in terms of the capture. Now, if I look at the Brio and look at how that looks, yes, the color profile is a bit closer, but it doesn't have that yellowy weird tinge to it. But, you know, there's no detail either. Like it's quite a bit different. So I'm gonna go ahead and record a couple of things full frame so you can get an idea of what this looks like. So this is the Logitech in its default kind of yellowish setting. And now we're gonna take a look at it with some of the optimizations that we just made in OBS. Okay, so this is the Logitech Brio. You can see that I've made all the changes here. I'm gonna record it in full frame and the camera with the different configurations to try to get rid of that yellow orange hue that kind of came with all the default settings through G Hub that I couldn't get rid of until I did the color correction, just to get an idea of what that looks like. And this is the Sony full frame camera. You know, the Sony does show a lot more lines and a lot more detail in terms of what I've got on my face and what's being captured, but it's a much better image in that sense than, you know, even the Brio has with its 4K sensor. All right, so it took quite a bit of fiddling on my side. I tried to make it not so long in terms of the time on camera to do all of those settings, but at least show some of the things that I did set. You know, color correcting within OBS and picking the right color is a little bit finicky, but it yields a much better result when you do that, because then you can get rid of some of those default weird hues like we saw with the Logitech Brio. The one thing to kind of note there, as you saw, was you want to use everything in a bit of moderation in terms of how far off pure white you want to go to correct, you know, some of the default tones. So I was able to knock out all of that yellowish tone from the Logitech Brio. And again, you know, OBS has the tools to do that, but it didn't quite have the detail that you can see through this camera. But, you know, it's a much less expensive camera, and it has other nice features to it, like it's got Windows Hello authentication built in. If this tip helps and makes your camera imagery and in some of the work that you're doing to stream online look better, please give me a like. Otherwise, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.